Hello students, welcome to the class on answer writing, and in this class I will be dealing with the approach to the answers of the questions that I have uploaded on brainiki.com on 15th of December. So the first question was, analyze the recent human development report. What lessons should India learn from it? Now the recent human development report, now what should be your approach to write an answer on this question? First of all, you must know about what is meant by human development report, and then you must know about the previous year rank of India. It was 135. Now you must know about the current rank of India. It is 130. Now what has India to learn out of this report? Now this report conveys that India has improved on the human development index. But this report has certain red flags. Now, what are those red flags? You must mention those red flags in your answers. Now, the number one red flag is that the women work participation, it has declined. The second red flag, rise in income doesn't mean that your human development index would also see an increase, because this report has also given an idea, kuch aise bhi desh hai jinka aarthik sthiti acha hai, but phir bhi wo human development index mein pichde hue hai un deshon se jinka ke aarthik sthiti hindu acha nahi hai. So what does this convey? It conveys that India should not only be focusing on growth, we should also be focusing on social infrastructure. Now what is meant by social infrastructure? It means drinking water, sanitation, health, schooling, education. So these are the areas that India should also be focusing on. Then the second question for the 15th of December is, Japan holds the potential to transform India into an ASEAN power. Now in this question, the approach should be to tell about the capacity and the capability of Japan. How Japan has the potential to transform India into an ASEAN power. The first thing, the approach you must highlight about the potency, about the capability, about the level of ingenuity that is held by Japan. Now Japan, it is among the top economic powers. Japan, it is among the top powers which are having very high technological levels. Japan is one such country that had provided aid to India. So by providing aid, by providing technology, by signing nuclear agreement, by helping India to join APEC, by helping India to join maybe in the future TPP, by helping India to strengthen its energy prospects, its education prospects, its health prospects, it can help India to transform into an ASEAN power. It can help India to balance out with China. It can coordinate, like the trilateral meet had already taken place in the month of September between India, Japan and United States of America. India need to leverage, India need to extract a lot out of that meeting in order to strengthen itself. Then the third question was about the recent developments. Now what has precipitated in Shanghai Corporation Organization meet? Now as far as SCO is concerned, Shanghai Corporation, very important change has taken place. Now what is that important change that has taken place? Your approach should be to focus on the very important change. Now when you look at the world economic order, it is moving towards alliances, it is moving towards groupism, it is moving towards creating polarization at the world diplomatic level. World diplomatic landscape is getting polarized. Use such terminology and such words. Zyada marks mil jate hain. Now, क्या चेंज आया है. नाउ रशिया इज गेटिंग क्लोज टू चाइना. अर्लियर दे वर नॉट फ्रेंडली नेशंस, देयर वाज लेस बोन हुमे, देयर वाज मोर काइंड ऑफ एंटागोनिज्म, देयर वाज नो काइंड ऑफ वॉर्मथ इन द रिलेशनशिप. बट ऑफ लेट देयर हैज बीन अ थॉ with respect to the irritants that were existing between China and Russia. And now China wants to dovetail, the word is dovetail, its Eurasian economic community with maritime trade economic corridor. Now it wants to dovetail both these projects. Now by dovetailing both these projects, they're actually trying to counter Turkey, they're trying to counter Saudi Arabia, and they're trying to counter United States of America. Though China is not fully ready to counter Saudi Arabia, but such projects certainly highlights that the world is getting divided into two halves. Now the structural reforms would assure the global economy to strengthen itself. What role can G20 play in it? Now the next meeting of the G20, it would be taking place in China. Now that meeting of the G20, now the China wants the agenda of that meeting to be decided now itself. Now what should be the agenda? Like the global economy, it is going down from 2008. Now we want to give a jump. We want to catalyze the global economy. How can that be catalyzed? That can be catalyzed if we will introduce domestic reforms, if we will introduce labor reforms, if we will introduce structural reforms, if we will not move towards protectionism. Now, this protectionism is a kind of a specter that we are currently facing. Most of the countries are trying to follow this creed, this line of protectionism. European Union wants protectionism. China don't want protectionism, and because of that it has devalued yuan. It wants its export-led growth to continue. Whereas, you look at the other parts of the world, they are already developed, and out of development they are promoting this export thing. But on the other hand, we have countries like Asian countries and China who are promoting their growth out of export. So G20 would be playing a very phenomenal role in deciding what the structural changes. And you can give examples of India, you can give an example of America, you can give example of France, you can give example of European Union. All these countries are jostling with economic crisis and how the reforms are needed. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.